Join the CACGM family this weekend, Saturday, March 26th, 2006, at the Colbury Primary School, Henker Road, Stratford, E15 1YJ, London, from 2 to 5 p.m. for their special Singles and Marriage Conference with our Reverend Dr. Archbishop Prince Daniel, ministering with the power of the Holy Ghost. You can't afford to miss this event. Be there. For more information, visit the CACGM website at www.cacgmtruthcenter.isourchurch.com. Hello, hello, and welcome to Send Me. We promote the gospel of Jesus Christ. Join us every Tuesday for Prayer Line. You can download our free app, Send Me Radio, from the Google and iTunes store, or log on to our website at www.sendme.co.uk. That's www.sends.co.uk.
And check out our newest magazine, Digital Ink, for inspirational stories, testimonies, and the latest on what's happening. That's digitalhink.com. DigitalHink.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, what you're about to hear is 100% vocals. 100% vocals.
Boy, me down in the country now. I'm not now one. But since me do a little interview with Digital Ink, my career just kick off.
I was down in the village praying for a miracle, and Digital Ink called me for an interview. And now I'm a celebrity, and now I travel to New York, Milan, London, Tokyo, all over the world. God bless. God bless. God bless.
Hello, welcome. For cutting edge interviews, articles, food and fashion, check out Digital online magazine where you are a celebrity. www.digitalhink.com.
Cherish one another as Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you. person for you. And please, I will come on the altars of the church. We wish all our pastors, all our fathers. Happy Father's Day. God bless you. As we're all here today, we have something wonderful for you. May the presence of God continue. Please don't share this to all our fathers. God bless you as carry on in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. So we quickly go on. He said, he that finds a wife, he that finds a wife, finds a good thing and obtains favor. Praise the Lord. The Bible even mentioned the woman finding the husband. Praise the Lord. He said, he who finds a wife finds a good thing. And not just good thing, has also obtained favor of the Lord. So quickly, please, can we just come to scriptures? Like I was earlier saying, we are different kinds of marriages, and so for that reason, people are getting confused when it comes to marriages. Like we are all sitting here today, we might be, most of us might be from Nigerians, other people from other parts of the world. Even in Nigeria, the culture differs. Even as Nigerians, maybe you're from Edo, even the culture in your home differs from the next culture. So as a result, there are going to be a lot of arguments, a lot of disagreements, a lot of ideas. But I believe as Christians, the best place, psalm and gifts, the best place you seek help, and the best place you go to is the Word of God. Amen. Amen. Because you grow in the same environment. Even if you are growing in the environment, even identical twins that grow in the same womb, their DNA is still different. Yeah. So there are differences. But what brings us together is the Word of God. And God expects each and some to be one. How can they be one when they are different? How can they be one when they are holding on to their differences? It is not possible. But thank God we have one word, Jesus Christ. And he gave us a map. He gave us a blueprint. He gave us a basic instruction that when we follow that, we shall have no differences. Even in the middle of our differences, we can come become one again in Jesus' name. So I want to quickly say to you, I don't know what you've heard about marriages. I don't know what kind of marriages you've seen. I don't know what might have inspired you. But I will show to you today, that when you've seen it, God's idea about marriage. Why marriage? Praise the Lord. And I'm going to be very brief, I promise, in Jesus' name. Quickly, if we turn to Genesis, praise the Lord. Somebody, Genesis 1:27. Because you can't build on a foundation you have no understanding. If a man sets a foundation for a bungalow, and you lost the architect's copy, and you say, oh, let me help. And if you don't lay, and you don't build upon that foundation, maybe 7-story building, will they last? No. You need to have understanding of the foundation that has been laid. And if you really wish them well, so you can know exactly how to build and what to build on. So if you must enjoy marriage that God has ordained, if you must come into marriage that God is talking about, then you need to go back to God, draw forth. You need to go back to the blueprints and find out, I desire to marry. Now I'm married. What do I do? Who do I come to? It's good to go to pastors. It's good to go to counselors. Fine. But to an extent, their suggestions and ideas can be contaminated, can be a bit not exact as God wants for you. But if you go back to your creator, praise the Lord, who has asked you that desire in you, you will never go wrong in Jesus' name. Amen. Are we together?
Oh, yes.
Genesis chapter 1, 27. Praise the Lord.
So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, created him. Male and female created in them. 28. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion over fish of the sea and over the fowls of the air and over everything that moveth upon the earth. 29. And God said, behold, I've given you everything, every seed, which is upon the face of all the earth. And every tree in the which is fruit of the tree of a tree yielding to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the earth, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, therein there is life. I have given every green herb for meat, and it was so.
Praise the Lord. Praise God, Jesus. So for the time, and to everyone, please let's hear God speak to us. When God had this idea, he blessed men and women as husband and wife before even their
marriage.
Your assignment in this marriage is that you both work together to exercise authority of dominion over creepy things. Over things that in the air, in the sea, on the land, wherever. And because he knows you will need energy,
he provided you meat. He said, for every green herb, you will find food. So the task God is giving to you in this marriage is that, listen, you walk as a king. I have given you a domain. I have given you a place on earth. So do not accept any law that wants to make you feel otherwise. God called you, blessed you, and multiplied you. You are yet to begin to see that. He said, listen, you must know and understand just this task. You have to take your possession on earth. You have to rule in your domain. You have to exercise God's authority in your domain. You have a place in God. You have a place on earth that God by yourself. So he said, it is not good that you be alone. He brought it's a gift. So I want to quickly say this is a gift. I don't like you have as a wife or how to be a wife. But I'm praying to you today, if you go to Jesus, so that the task that's given to Brother Sam will be so enormous. He can't do it alone. He brought it from his reading. Come. Be the help that is enough for his weakness. So today I charge you, any weakness you find in this man, it's your responsibility to bring strength. Don't be like those who are saying, don't mind the foolish man. All your plans are buying here. Look at you, you are still struggling from God to God. That is your role. If that is your dream, God can bring me here. But we don't walk together.
Yes, sir.
Sam cannot be alone. I'll give him a help. For his weakness. Because as a king, he cannot flaunt about his domain and his weaknesses.
Yes,
he must reign in dignity and honor.
Yes, sir.
He must rule as a king with honor. So, gifts come forth and be that strength in weakness. Begin to see in yourself God, the Holy Spirit, your helper. We know the role of the Holy Spirit, the helper. And that's what our role is. So every wise woman, each time you see the weakness in your husband, go on your knees. God, what do I do with this? Because the only assignment a wife has as a whole is to fill the gap. I don't believe in women coming to say, my husband did not do this for me. He said, I'm not saying men don't change because it's also in the Bible. But first, if we see and get that understanding, and this marriage will make it work. And I'm here so that to ensure you excel. Sam, what do you do? Speak to him. I said, as you go to walk out, you will excel today because I'm going to be on my knees.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. As you go forward, you will not fail because I'm going to talk